First, we add a sliding door. To have the right wall thickness for the door settings dialog, pick up the parameters of the load-bearing wall with the pickup tool or pipette. Activate the door tool. Open its settings dialog and type pocket in the search field. Select pocket door. Set the door settings as follows. Width, 1 meter. Height, 2.10 meters. Anchor sill to story 0, 0.00. Anchor, side 2. General Settings tab page. No casing. Door frame on. Pocket frame on. Frame and leaf tab page. Centered leaf off. Leaf offset 0.125. Please don't forget to set model unit decimals to 3 on the working units panel to be able to enter 3-degree decimals. Click OK. Place the first door to the lower left corner of the entrance room. There are 2 walls that meet at that point. Click in the corner. Click the upper right arrow for the opening direction so that the leaf will open to the right and the pocket will be placed between the 2 walls and the insulation skin. You can see that the door is not in a convenient position to allow entry to the interior space. Select it and press the Ctrl or Command plus D shortcut and drag it to the right. Type D0.6 into the tracker and move the door by 60 centimeters. Deselect the door. Now, let's add some more doors to the future restroom area. Activate the Door tool. Open its Settings dialog. Select the door object from the Hinged Doors folder. Set this door as follows. Size 0.75 by 2.10. Anchor. Sill to story 0 to 0.00. Reveal to wall core 0.00. Anchor, side 1. Door leaf type and handle tab page. Door leaf type, style 56. Tags. Non-load-bearing element. Interior. Door. Apply predefined rules page. IFC interior doors at the Manage IFC properties. Click OK. Place doors so you can enter all rooms easily. Insert the first door into the horizontal wall. After inserting the door, you can drag them to their final desired position. Select the door and enter -0.10 for the reveal to core value in the info box. Insert the second door and drag it if necessary. Select this door and enter -0.02 for the reveal to core value in the info box. We'll place a door into the external wall of the gallery, which is identical to the one at the entrance. Open the 1 gallery floor plan and turn on tracing. We want to have exactly the same door as the entrance door. To have all settings and parameters, we use the pickup tool on the standard toolbar. This tool sets all parameters of the element as default for that tool. Activate the pickup tool and move the cursor over the door on the trace reference until the info tag appears with basic information about the door. Click once. Notice that the door tool is activated at the same time. Please note, if you have overlapping elements on the floor plan, you can hit the tab key to switch between the elements. Set the door anchor to side 1. Place a door into the horizontal external wall close to the short vertical wall segment. Select it and move it to the intersection point of the short vertical wall segment and the horizontal wall. You can also use a guideline if necessary. Please note, the outer wall side you pick when you place a door or window sets the direction of the sill and board. If you want to change the opening direction, use the flip command. This has no effect on the wall side settings.